My name's Matt Ferguson. Right, we're out here in the dangerous wilderness of Nelson Lynch, Ohio. I don't even know if that's the city. My cell phone's going off. Don't tell anyone I have it out here. You're not supposed to. Shh. Right. Now, if something were to happen, it's a decent day out right now, but if it was start to rain, I would get soaking wet. My phone's going off again. I think it's the president. He might be a big fan of the show. Big fan of the show. He doesn't really watch TV. But whatever. If something were to happen, it's not raining, I'd get soaked. I would get very, very ill. There's a small cave up here. Let's check it out. Right. Now, here's the cave. Let's check it out. Right, now as you can see, it's quite wet. It looks like it rained earlier this week, but it's still very narrow, so we have to watch out for any monstrous creatures. Hello? There's no doorbell or anything, so I can't really just ring. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Right, I think it's good. Now I can see light on the other side. I think we should go around to the other side. I'm kind of a bigger fellow, and I can't really fit in through this narrow space. Alright, let's go.
Hi, I'm Matt Ferguson from TV's Matt Ferguson's Outdoor Adventures. When I'm out in the wilderness and I get thirsty, I don't grab for H2O. The world's covered in that. What do I grab for? I grab for my trusty Mountain Dew. It really quenches my thirst on a hot day. On top of that, it's delicious!
Do the deal! Oh.
Right, we've reached the other side of the cave. Now this seems like it would fit a very large person like myself. It would keep me semi-dry. The bugs are crazy. Keep me semi-dry. It would start to rain or thunderstorm, and these rocks, they're sturdy as a bone. As a rock, I don't know. Let's investigate the cave. Wait, we have to check again. Hello!
Hello! Hello!
I think it's good. Oh, yes. This is good. Because the passage is very deep. So I can kind of sit on this rock, start a fire right here, and at night, if it were to stop raining or bad weather, I could crawl right up under there and sleep. It's a very dark place, and it's got this nice big rock that I wouldn't get hurt. Alright, let's remember where this is and let's keep moving. I'm back again. We know where the cave is, but look at these giant rocks! You can tell that they used to be connected. And due to erosion, I learned about that in high school, they've now fallen down and created these dark caves. That one would be even better for me to sleep in, so I can start a fire over here and sleep in there. It's a lot larger. Also, over here, you can tell there used to be tourists in this part of the country, but there's a beer bottle. Very good. I can take that with me if I have to urinate, and any enemies come, I can throw it at them. That's for you, Dick Clark. Alright, let's keep walking up here and see what we can find. Crikey, now this is a very deep ravine. Once I live on this moss here, and I could go right over. So I have to be very careful. There's danger, danger, danger here. Whoa. Keep my footing in good. Whoa. That's very deep. Alright. We're moving on still trying to find a nice cave or place to camp for the night. Because I can see these thunderheads moving in and I don't want to get hurt. I don't want to get struck by lightning. I don't want to get deafened by thunder. Not that can actually happen, but you never know. I've read studies. I don't want to get soaked, because if I get wet, I could possibly get hypothermia, pneumonia, any number of things. So we're going to head out for a campground and find some damn bug spray. Alright, let's move on out.
Coach Hugo Manzik, the Hawaiian Falcon Flies. Do my players want to quench their thirst? What do they go for? Mountain. Do the do.
Crikey, alright. It's a very large ravine down there. So we have to worry, one slip could prove fatal. Right, let's keep walking. I can see the sun's beginning to set, so we really need to hurry up now. Let's push on. Alright, there's a small cave. It's like a path right through here. Now, judging by the way the sun is, I'm going to say not to go here, because this is all mossy, which means... my loyal viewers would know, moss grows on the north side. So being moss, sun rising east, we're good. We're gonna push on this way and keep looking for a large cave. I know there's gotta be some around here, because judging by these rocks in this pass, I'm sure there is. Let's go find one.
La 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 bam bam.
Woo! Right, let's go. Found this great stick. It's gonna be perfect, it's nice and thick, good height. I can use it for a walking stick. So, I mean, there's lots of leaves as you can see. One slip and I could just fall right in any ravine. I could fall all the way down the hill. Any number of things. Walking stick is a very good thing to have. It's getting dark, so I really have to try. I found a few other caves, but they really weren't what we were looking for. So, you're gonna need to find some place, some kind of shelter for the night. Alright, let's head off.
Do the do.
Alright, I'm Matt Ferguson. It's getting really dark, okay? We really have to find a place to camp out for the night. And you know what? I found the perfect shelter. The perfect place. Dry, warm, and sleep from animals. And here it is! The perfect way to go! Alright, so